In this video, I'm gonna show you how to make the abstract wallpaper you saw in the preview of this video. We will go through all these steps to create this illustration and touch on the Blender errors that can occur in the process to make this render work for everyone. So, let's get started. So, first of all, I would like to say that if you are having trouble with a particular step, you can follow the link in the description to the Gumroad page where you can purchase the source with step-by-step collections for only $2. Let's create a torus with a major radius something about 0.8, I think. And let's add subdivision surface modifier with high enough values for I think 6 steps for viewport and 7 for render. We need them in order not to use the experimental adaptive subdivision function because it requires more resources. This modifier is crucial for creating future details. Then we need to bend this torus with simple deform. Let's add it. Which is twist with the following values. I think something like this will be enough for our render. And let's add camera. And immediately set the resolution. One moment. Yeah. And immediately set the resolution to 1600 and 1200. Yeah. We also need to set the focal length to 100. Yeah. To reduce the effect of perspective distortion. Now we need to find a nice way to place the object in the camera. You can do any rotation you like, but for me I'll set probably minus 32 on the X axis, 17 on the Y, and I think 88. Will be great on the Z axis, and place everything in the center. So I think something like this. Next, we are going to work through the basic lighting so we can have a slightly better handle on what we are seeing. Let's remove the lights of our world completely. To make the shadows more contrasty and darker. As we rotation the object, if you are confident, you can set the light sources however you want, or you can just follow my lead and set the three area lights as follows. So let's add this. I think something like that. And set it to 200 maybe. So let's see, and another one here. And one on the top. Maybe here. Yeah. Now we can see the volume on our object, and we can add texture to it. But before that, we need to add one plane to the background. Let's add it. And we need to add one on the bottom. So just duplicate by pressing Shift D. The bottom one will give a light reflex on our object. Here you can see the effect of this plane. So yeah, let's put it here. Now begins the most interesting part, because we should create a beautiful material. So let's add a new one, and don't forget to go to settings, then surface, and let's select displacement only. Otherwise we won't be able to add beautiful details for the torus. Next, everything is simple. Let's go to the shading and then add a displacement node and connect it. We need a displacement node with a small value for scale. I think something about 0.150 will be just right. We also need to set metallic to 1 and roughness to 0.3 to get some shine. Let's add noise texture, then mapping. Of course we should connect it. And texture coordinate in generated mode, so that we do not have seams on the texture. Later we will return to the possible errors that may occur and how to solve them. Let's connect noise texture to see our changes. So values for noise texture I have picked up based on beforehand, so you can just repeat them. Let's select 4D and then scale to 0.9, detail to 15, and distortion to 1. So yeah, we need something like that. The main thing to remember is that you need in the node mapping set everywhere 0 in the item scale, except for the z-axis, which we need to stretch very much to get the desired effect of stripes. So let's do this. Let's just add select 0, 0 and something like that. And now we have our stripes. After the noise texture, we need to add a color ramp and pick the colors you think you need. So let's add it and connect this here. So yeah, let's create white color. Then I've prepared my palette here, so you can just copy this. So let's select, then copy, and let's create red color. Then I think we should create green. Just copy. Let's create one more pin, and the last one is brown. I think something like this, maybe. Oh, where is my brown color? Just copy, shading, and paste. Yeah, but I need a little bit more green, I think. So let's move it. Yeah, so now we have our colors. After that we need to create another color ramp to connect it to the displacement. Color ramp, let's move it here, connect to a factor, and we need to transfer the black and white color information to create the small details. Actually, to create all our details. Let's connect it to height. And now we have, let's see, now we have our details. Let's see it on the render. Now we have almost what we need. The only thing left is to finalize the scene at a dark green color. I think something like this, to the background plane, and let's move it back and create another area light to lighten it up a bit, and those make a small gradient for the background. Let's select disk and green color too. Yeah. Now let's add a few point lights to make some highlights on our object. This will make it more voluminous and attractive. So yeah, let's add it. I think you see that it looks better than before. And of course you can add it however you want. And now we can talk about solving the problem when your texture stops laying on the object correctly. This will probably happen when you re-enter Blender, so there are one way to fix it. You can disable the simple deform modifier and then enable it again. And now it works, or you can just delete this and create a new one. It's probably a bug, but in the version 3.6 this method works, but if you are watching me when it's already fixed, you can try to place the texture by UV, but then you'll have to hide the seam. So let's set up the render settings. Let's do 256 samples so that this render doesn't take too long, and set the appropriate contrast in color management. I'll choose medium high contrast, or maybe lower medium contrast. So yeah, okay, and you can move your camera however you want to select a right angle for your for your new wallpaper. And if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. All my next videos will be in English, and I'll do my best. So, goodbye.